It's time to get this one out. I'm going to get it out. Got my boy Craig here. He's going to polish it for me. He's going to try and make this turd look better. I've got all the panels over there. So let's do this.
A spray attachment on it. Yeah. Huh? Yeah, I know. What we can do is we can drive it up there and put panels on it. You gonna wash it? What I'm going to do is I've got all the suspension out, so I think what I'm going to do is try and get the rear on, get some rear wheels on it, and then maybe round up a couple of people and try and get this car up here. I don't know why it matters so much, but it just feels like I'll have more space to work.
Might be a little more.
And then I'm going to prime the back and prime some bit. Progress is slow today, but Craig is up there washing the car off. He's polished the whole thing. We went and got some fuel because it ran out. So now that's running great. I'll get some more footage of it in a bit. And then on this, got one corner built up, and I've had to grind an absolute ton away from the bushes because there's a little bit of a problem, so that's going to have to be addressed. Just a case of making new lower control arms, easy enough. And then I think I'm going to cut the arch up to this line. Also, I've managed to misplace an upper wishbone. So somewhere I've got a standard one,
So I'm just going to put that on for the minute. Sticks out further than the other, which is odd. That's got way more camber on it.
That could account for half inch.
Yeah, that's what she said. So now I'm going to pop the engine out. I'm going to prime everything that's not primed, apart from the subframe. Now I'm going to prime the back. Bye! There goes Craig, my polisher. So I've got the engine out, primed some stuff, put the engine and box back in, got the tunnel in. I'm quite happy with it. It looks pretty decent. It'll do for now. The wheel's on. For some reason, this wheel sticks out way further than the other wheel. And I got a little bit worried about subframe position, but me and my old man did some measurements and we can't actually work out where the problem is. So it's probably like a little bit in the quarter, a little bit in the arch, a little bit in the camber, a little bit in the toe. I'm going to carry on. I'm going to get the front suspension on. I'm going to try and get it down on its front wheels. And then I'm going to call it a night because it's 10:15 already. 9:15, sorry. Here we go then. The Rifto Micra on its wheels. Pretty epic. God knows what I'm going to do about this. Not bad. What the fuck? So, I really hope that everything's in line with each other and it's just toe and camber that's the problem there. But how sick is this? It's on its wheels, supporting its own weight. And the wishbones, you can't really see, but the wishbones in there have got room to operate up and down. A bit squeaky on this side, and the arms are adjusted as far as out as they'll go, so it's worst case scenario. Loads of clearance for lock, I hope. I haven't actually checked. That's what the back end looks like. I think the exhaust suits it fairly decent. That's not enough arch clearance, and that is way too much ground clearance. Should I cut the tubs out? I don't know. Look at the angle of the arms. They're pretty much bang on at this ride height. So now what I want to do, I'll quickly show you this. But it rolls. Sick. I'm going to call it a night now. At what stage can I claim or start telling people that I own a rear-wheel drive Micra? Doesn't quite feel right just yet. I mean, it's got an engine and box and a rear subframe in it. It's rear wheel drive, isn't it? Sick.
Right. Cheers for me. It is the day after the show, and the show was great. If you're into tractors, I am glad that I put in the effort to get this out in the field, because it was such a good feeling to see this car out there, parked next to my Skyline and my my little Micra Street Racer. It got quite a lot of interest from various people. I think a lot of people were glad to see it. Surprising amount of interest for a tractor show, to be honest. Although, it kind of is a tractor, I suppose. So, I'm probably not going to do much this week because I'm tired. Arch gap, speak about that in a minute. Anyway, I've got some scales that I've borrowed from work. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to throw this up on the scales. Probably go to the shed, get doors, boot lid, and a few other bits and bobs that I can easily just throw in the car or attach to the car. I'll make a note of everything that I've got fitted in the car at the moment. So I'll make a note, like kind of like a spreadsheet, and then as I go along, I'll just weigh bits and bobs and just add them to the spreadsheet, and then that'll give me a bit of a ballpark of what this car may end up weighing. The goal is still 800 kilos, I guess, but anything lighter than an MX-5 will be a bonus.
You need to ignore the front left and left to right and front to rear split, because none of the springs, you know, that's all to do with the corner weighting. And because it's sat on like random bits of wood in there, and bit of box section on the rear on each side, it's completely out because all the spring, it's not sat on its springs basically, it's sat on wood or box section, so the splits are just not right. Sorry if I'm talking rubbish and not making much sense, but I'm rather tired. Anyway, the next stage now is to pile some weight on there. But initially, that is quite concerning, 575. It basically means that to get under my target weight, I can only add another 225 kilos. And as you can see, it's still pretty bare. So I think the chances of me keeping this under 800 kilos is going to be fairly slim.
but I will
carry on.
This isn't going to deter me.
Yo, so I just chucked a couple of bits in there. Handbrake, it's not the handbrake I'm using, but it'll simulate the weight, I guess. And a pedal for the throttle. So the weight now is 5.78.5. I've got some parts out of the shed, arches, drive shafts, anti-roll bars, column, prop, wings, grill, and the bumper. And then I've got some more bits here. Headlights, radiator, intercooler, an old downpipe, some boost pipes. I'll be changing the boost pipes for aluminium, so that'll save some weight. And I've also got the bonnet over there, the rusty bonnet from back in the day. So what I'm going to do now is just lift all this in the car, and I'm going to call out what I'm putting in and record the scales as I go. So then I can watch the video back and write down all the gubbins. I've also got tailgate and doors to get out of the shed. I've got no glass for the sides, but they're going to be perspex. So if I leave the windscreen, the tailgate glass, the door glass, that's going to more than cover perspex rear quarter windows. It will all be perspex eventually, and the sunroof will be going. So yeah. I want to go home, so I'm just going to hustle this out now. I mean, I've only been here half an hour, but
I've already had enough because it's been a long week. So, if I set this up somewhere where you can see what's going on, can we read that? 5.78.6. So, with any luck, I'll be able to read this when I edit. Let's go for heavy stuff first. The column. Drive shafts. One shaft. Two shaft. Anti-roll bars, sway bars, I guess. Prop. Prop spam. Big lump of alley for prop spacer. Let's get that in there. Big lumber valley for the prop spacer. Front bumper. Let's lay this across the front. Grill. Front wings. One wing. Two wing. Arch kit. Headlights. Downpipe, starter motor, Elbusto pipage for the spoolie boy, this is pretty rad. Thank you.
old spoolie cooler. So now, all we need is doors and tailgate. Just can't. Right, we've got tailgate. One more door to go, and we're at 600. There we go. 717 kilos. I kind of place stuff kind of where it's going. So left to right weight split is sick. And to be honest, front rear is also sick. Probably should put a battery in there, shouldn't I? To simulate the weight of the battery. Right, that's the... I'll find a battery, I'll pop that in, and then that's the last thing. The battery. And the fuel tank box. There we go. We've got front calipers, but we don't have rear calipers. 732 kilos. I'm gonna go home. I've got a nice keg of Copperberg. Cock? A nice keg of cock? Got a nice keg of Copperberg to dig into. So that is on the agenda tonight. Sorry, I'm just filming a useless screen. Let's have a look. There you go. So I've got some Copperberg to... Copperberg. Bye. Forgot to say, roll cage. 59 kilos of roll cage tube. Probably not going to buy any more. So add 59 kilos to the list. Bye.